Welcome everyone. So in this video, we will be looking at VLOOKUP function with approximate matching. That means with the true argument in the fourth position. Okay, so in the previous video, which I will put in the link in the description, we discussed about what is VLOOKUP function and also a few examples. Right, so now we look at the next example, which is using approximate matching. So over here, we will illustrate, like for example, if we were to use ID, right? So this is just to show that when you are using true argument, what will happen. So it's just a small recap. We also talked about this thing in the previous video, right? So B11, select the range, press F4 to lock it. In this case, whether you lock it or not, doesn't really matter. Return the third column and it is a true argument, right? So true argument. So you can see that we get a 41. So when you type in a 6, you get 23 because 6 is nearest to 5. So how does the approximate matching work? It's basically trying to search the largest number that is smaller or equal to what you are searching. Okay, so the sentence it could be a bit confusing. That means you are searching a number 6, right? They will search number 6 in this table, or the largest number that is smaller than 6. The largest number that is smaller than 6. So 5 is the largest number, smaller than 6, 23, right? So if you change this to 5.1, still 23. 4.5, can we have 4.5? Yes, you get 90, right? Because 4 is the largest number that is smaller than or equal to 4.5. Time in a 4, 90 as well, 3.99. Then you will get 69. Let's press enter, you get 69. So this is how the approximate matching works. But one thing to take note is that approximate matching, you must ensure that what you are searching is sorted in ascending order. So let's look at this one. So this is actually the same situation, right? So it's just the same thing, 10, and then of course we do a VLOOKUP of the 10, and then just another practice similar with just now. So without locking the range is also fine because we are not copying the formula downwards. Okay, 3 and then true. Then you can see 41. Then when you type in 11, you still get 41. So there's no ID 11 here. So there are a lot of situations you want to ensure that you are using exact matching. Okay, so approximate matching is only used in a very specific condition or situation. So unless you know what you are actually looking at or trying to search, otherwise I would recommend try to use exact matching rather than approximate matching. Okay, because in this case, for example, if I want to know student ID number 11, what is the marks? But student ID number 11 probably are absent that day, right? So the mark should be not available, not 41. So if you change this thing to a false argument, then you will know that, okay, student 11, ID 11 absent that day, right? So we know this thing. Otherwise, if you are using true argument, you may think that, okay, student 11 actually attended or present, and then he scored 41, but that is actually the marks for student ID 10, right? So you don't want this thing to happen. This actually happens quite common. It's a common mistake, okay, when you are using VLOOKUP function. So try to avoid this thing. So now we look at the situation where the range is not sorted in ascending order, right? So for example, we do the same thing, ID number 10, and then we do a VLOOKUP, and then select the whole range. Remember, we mentioned just now that we are using a true argument, approximate matching, right? So 10, you get 41. It's okay, right? So let's see 11. You get 41, it's the same. So although in this case, we still don't want this thing to happen. I mean, you don't want number ID 11 actually gets the mark, but we just try to demonstrate, illustrate what happened if it is not sorted in ascending order. Compared to the previous table, you can see that we are actually interchanging the two rows, okay? So 20 and 30, we interchange the position. Okay, now, what is the ID 20, the score? 41. how come stock ID get 41? ID 20 should be getting 59, right? So Excel somehow did a wrong calculation. And so it's not because we did a wrong argument. Okay, so if you are using false argument, then you can see that you will get what you need. Okay, but if you are using true argument, you get 41. Why is it 41? So that is a question that you may want to ask, right? So that relates to how the searching is actually being done. Okay, so if you search like 21, it's still 41, right? So it's very interesting, 29 is still 41, and then you search 31, we see what happened. 30, you get 69, which is correct. Okay, and then 31 also 59. Okay, how come 31 become 59? We mentioned that true argument is actually searching the largest number that is smaller than what you are searching, right? So 30 is actually the largest number that is smaller than 31. So number that are smaller than 31 is 10, 30 and 20. So it should be returning 69, not 59. But why is it 59? Okay, so that is basically the error happens here because we are not sorting this one in ascending order. Okay, so that relates to the searching algorithm. Okay, so for example, if you look at this 31, right? So we will make it in short and more intuitive, so we won't go into the details of the searching. Of course, if you are interested, you can always search, like for example, we look up. Okay, so you can click at this one, and then it will basically bring you to this Microsoft documentation, and then you can actually read through this one. So we can actually make this thing larger, change it to this text preferences. Okay, good. So should be able to view from here. So this is the documentation from Microsoft support website, right? So you can try to use the new XLOOKUP function, of course, if you are using the new version of Excel. So if not, then you can see that the range lookup, so you get everything. Let me directly search the truth. Okay, so it's not indicated here, but you can actually it should be let me see. Okay. Okay, so you can see that over here the range lookup is you can see that the argument, right? So like what we mentioned in the previous video, we say that the range lookup, if it is left out, right, so the first column must be sorted alphabetically or numerically. So if not, then it's not sorted, then you may not get what you expect, which is what happens here, what happened in this this example, right? Okay, so of course it seems like the default value is actually taking the will always be a true. Okay, the default value is always a true. Of course this is in the documentation here, but you can see that if over here, if I leave out this argument, so it is actually a false. Okay, it is actually a false. Okay, so if you leave this thing out, and then you see I leave it in empty, it is actually a false here. Okay, so of course you can also even remove the comma. Okay, if you remove the comma, then it will become the true argument. Okay, so for this case here, I will make it in slightly more detail. So the first thing we want to know is that the false and true. Okay, so of course false and true here, we are talking about this thing is false is exact matching, right? So remember we talk about exact matching, and then this is approximate matching. Okay, and of course in the documentation it's mentioned that this is actually the default value. Okay, So this is the default value. So in the previous video, I mentioned that I'm actually looking at the version that I have here. This is a default value here, right? So this is what I have in my version. So actually, this is a mistake, and then of course it is actually due to this thing here. So let's look at this one. So if you omit the, let me zoom in so that we can see in a larger font. So if we omit the argument in this way, I put a comma and then I omit it. So you see, I have a comma and then I don't type anything, I press enter. This will become exact matching, okay? So this, in this case, this is exact matching. So false argument is taken, false argument is taken. If I remove the comma, the last comma, true argument will be taken, okay? True argument will be taken. So why is it so? Actually, this is something when you press a comma here, although I don't type in anything, so Excel will read this empty string and becomes a value 0, okay? So that value 0 is actually a false. So true false is binary, so this is actually 0 1, okay? So why is it 0 1? You can actually sort of like doing the same. Say I take false plus 1, I get a 1. You see, it should be 0 plus 1. True plus 1, I get a 2. It should be 1 plus 1, okay? So false is actually 0, true is actually 1 0, or true false, right? So this is binary. So when I put in a comma here, so this is one thing that I have made a mistake in the previous video, that I mentioned that if I do it this way, the default value is actually true. I mean, default value is actually false, right? So I mean, in this case, if you put a comma and then press enter, it is actually a false, but it is not because you omit the there are two situations, right? So you omit the argument but you have a comma, so Excel read this argument as empty string, and empty string then will be converted to this 0. So it is similar with this case, I type in a 0, so it's a exact matching. If I use a 1, then it's a true, then it's approximate matching. So you can see that the last argument here, we have few different ways. So for you to get exact matching, you can type in a false, okay? You can type in a 0, or you can choose not to type in anything. So you will get false matching, okay? Exact matching. If you need approximate matching, remove the last comma, you will get approximate matching. Okay, so in order to get that, then basically you can type in the false, you can type in a 0, you can type in nothing, okay? Don't type anything to get this exact matching, okay? So for the true argument, you type in a true, of course, or you type in a 1, or you don't type in anything, okay? Even without the comma, without last comma, okay? So these are the few different ways, okay? So this one is the so-called the default value indicated in this website here, okay? So the default value will always be true, okay? So that is what you have here, and then you can always search on the documentation, and then that is the function. Okay, so now let's go back to the searching part here, right? So when we say that, okay, so this case we omit even the last comma, right? So I put in a 1 is a true, so you can also do something like this. Okay, so why is 31 returning 59? So basically it works in this way. You see, when you are searching 31, right, so you look at the table, because you are not sorting the table in ascending order, but Excel wouldn't know that you did not sort this table in ascending order. So what will happen is that Excel will assume that this is in ascending order, okay? So take the first number, look at 10. 10 is less than 33, correct? Correct. Okay, so now move to the half of the table, 20. Is 20 less than this one? Still yes, correct? So it's still less than 31. And then look at this part, half of it, which is 40, right? So 40 is greater than 31. Okay, so 40 is up. So because we are searching the largest number that is smaller than 31. So that means no more number in between 20 to 40. So 20 is the largest, written 59. Okay, so again, So you can see, we look at 10. 10 is less than 31, correct? Correct. Okay, so this is less than 31. Then you take the whole table. Of course, you can sort of like take the last one. That is the searching, right? So 50 is greater than 31. Okay, so the largest number that is smaller than 31, it will be in between here, right? In between the first row to the last row. So take the middle, 20. 20 is still less than 31, correct? So take the, so now 20 is less than 31, 50 is greater than 31. So the largest number will happen, largest number that is smaller than 31 will happen in between here, in between here. So take the middle again, which is this one. So compare here. So 31 is in between here, then it should be definitely this row, right? So that's why you get 59 here. So of course, if you change this thing to like something, say 35, then you probably get 69, this number already. Okay, so you can see things works differently now. So why is it 69 now? Okay, so let's try one more time. 10 is less than 31. 50 is greater than 31. So it will happen in the middle, somewhere in between these two rows, right? So the largest number, take the middle. 35 is greater than this number, agree? Yes. So 35 greater than this number, that means the largest number that is smaller than 31 will happen in this part. So it's like a binary search. You always cut half, look at which part, which half contains the number, the largest number. And then you cut half, look at which half that has the largest number. Okay, so in between here, so you look at 30 in the middle. 30 is less than this one, correct? Correct. 35 is greater than, so the largest number happens in the middle, in between these two rows. But these two rows has no other rows in between, so it will always take this row. Okay, so if let's say you change this to 30.5, then what happened? You get back 59, right? So very interesting. Again, this is less than it, this is more than, so you take in the middle, it's still less than. So now the largest number happened in this lower half. Take the middle again, it's larger than 31, so it should be in the upper half of the second half. So in the here, so first row, 59. So that's how the search works. Okay, so having consider the searching part, and also of course the true and false here, then we move on to some situation where you are dealing with when you need this approximate searching. For example, if let's say you have a range of marks, and then you say that okay, these are grades. So you want to this is not sales, this is marks, and then grades, right? So given the marks, you want to get the grade. So how do we do this thing? So 0 to 50, 0 50 to 75, 75 to 100, and 100. So okay, right. So one of the ways is that of course you can actually move it here. I just want to create one more column, right? So call this as like lower bound. Okay, so this is 0, 50. It shouldn't be percentage, so let me change the formatting to number first. Okay, right, so 0, 50, and 75, and 100. Okay, so now what happened? You can do the, let's say, 32. What is the grade? We look up of the 32 marks, and then select in this way, comma, return to, and then true argument. Okay, so you know that 32 marks is a fail. So what if 50? It should be B, right? So 74, still a B. 75, 8, 100, A plus. So you get what you need. So over here is the lower bound of the range, and then observe that the range always is like inclusive, right? So that means this is the fail grade. 0 is the lowest. B is the lowest, 50. Lowest marks or lowest number for A is 75, and so on. Okay, so this is the lower bound of the grade. And then you do a VLOOKUP with approximate matching here. Okay, so this is one of the situation. And in normal circumstances, you may not be dealing with marks and grade. You may be dealing with, for example, sales and commission. Okay, so sales amount can be decimal now. So there are a few ways of dealing with this thing. You look at this one, exactly at 1000 point. You see, this part and this part is a little bit different because you have the lower bound here. That means what? That means like when the marks hit 75, the student get A. If the marks is 74.9 or 74, it should be a B, right? So you have the lower bound exactly is inclusive. It's left hand inclusive, okay? But here is right hand inclusive. So what? How do we deal with this thing? So if we do the same thing here, you can see that you may get some error. Okay, so let's try one more time. So this is second situation, which is common. So of course, in real life, it depends on where is the inclusive part, right? So, but I purposely use this this right hand inclusive so that we can see different situation. Okay. Right. So now lower bound is zero, and then 1000, and then of course this is 2000, 3000, 4000, right? So if you do the lower bound in this way, say if you perform the lower bound in this way, so I get a sales of 900, let's say, right? So what is the commission? So we do the same thing, VLOOKUP of the 900, select the two column, press a comma, two and false, sorry, true. Right, so it's true argument, you get a 5%, so it looks good here. So let's change this thing to 5%. Okay, so it looks good here. So how about 1000? 7%. Is it correct? No, because 1000 is included here, it should be a 5%, correct? So things become a little bit more tricky because this is right hand inclusive. This part here is left hand inclusive. So of course for marks, most of the time we have the cutoff point 75, then you go beyond that. Okay, so in this case, it's slightly different. Okay, so let's say 2009%, right? So is 2009% not really, right? So it should be actually 7% because based on the description here. So one of the way of dealing with this thing is that, take note that this is, of course, we cannot enumerate all the possible scenario, but in this case it's dealing with money, right? So usually you have $1 and 20 cents, 25 cents, and so on. So you can add a third decimal to here so that it becomes slightly larger. Okay, so for example, let me just change all these things to value, right? So 1000 2000 3000 4000. So I basically, this one no need to change because zero is inclusive. Okay, so this one, 1000, right? So 1000 is actually not belonging to this row. So can we say that this is 999? Actually can, if let's say you ensure that everything is integer, then no issue. You can see 2000, you get 9%. Okay, okay, sorry, this should be, let me undo a bit. 1001. Because it's greater than 1000, right? So 2001 and then 3001 and 4001. Then you can see that 2000, you actually get 7%. You get what you need already. So 2001, you get 9%. So this works fine. Okay, but if let's say the sales has some decimal here, 2000.50. So should it be still 7%? Based on the description, it should be 9% now because it's more than 2000. So having $1 actually is too large, the incremental. So you actually may want to do something like this, 0.001. So that usually in terms of dollar or in terms of amount, you have 10 cents, 15 cents, 25 cents, but you don't have 25.1 cents. Okay, so you have the 0.1 here. And then same thing here, 0.001. okay, so I just repeat the same thing here, and in this case you will get what you need. So for whatever amount, as long as up to two decimal, this is fine. Okay, so of course we cannot enumerate all the possible scenario. This is one of the scenario where you want to deal with VLOOKUP with true argument. Okay, so in the last example, it will be slightly more technical where we deal with some of the mathematical contents here. where we want to simulate a random number from discrete distribution. Okay, so this is talking about inverse transform method. So for those who are interested to know about these simulation methods, you can watch the other video. Okay, so the other video we talk about what is simulation and also what is inverse transform method. So there are a lot of things under this simulation topics, but we only discuss a few. Not a few, but we only discuss one method, which is the inverse transform method. Okay, so now in this case here, for those who are not interested in this technical part, you may want to skip this part here. But for those who are interested in this maths, you can actually look at this thing. So how do we deal with or generate a random number or simulate a random number from discrete distribution? So in order to deal with that, you have to look at what is inverse transform method. Basically, we want to look at this CDF, right? So we may want to have something like this now. Instead of less than, but instead of equal, we want to have less than or equal to, which is, this is the CDF, right? So this is actually the CDF, cumulative density function. Then we say that, okay, so it should be this one plus the current number. And the last row should be equal to a number one. So that is correct. Okay, so the column D now is a CDF and column C is PMF. Okay, so now to generate two steps. First step, you generate a random number from uniform distribution from 0 to 1. So in Excel, you can use R and D function. So you get a random number from uniform distribution. So how does this number relates to the X here? So it's basically this one, right? So, but of course the X here is on the right hand side, so you cannot actually do a VLOOKUP. So we will actually use a VLOOKUP. So let me copy and then of course it's ready here. Do some formatting. Okay, good, right? So I paste, I created another columns here so that we can actually do a VLOOKUP. Okay, so now VLOOKUP of the random number generator just now, and then select these two columns, and then put a comma, and then say it is 2, and then of course this is a true argument. Okay, so let's check. 0.23 is actually below this one but greater than this one, right? So it should be a 2. Okay, so that is the inverse transform method. So you can see we can generate number from what, 1 to 5. Okay, so I saw a... Okay, right, so okay, sorry, we need to do some adjustment here. This is the CDF on the column D, so I missed out one of the step. So this is column D, right? So if let's say we say 0.01, so you will get an A, right? So because this is not the lower bound, this is actually the upper bound. Okay, so let's go back to this one. So it is similar in this case here, but the CDF is actually the upper bound, right? So you want to change a lower bound here. So I should have this one and then lower bound. So this lower bound should be 0 and then should be this number and so on. Okay, so that means what? That means from 0.06 to 0.18 is for number 2. Okay, now you will have this generator like this, and then you change it to here. Okay, so in this case then you will see that you won't get an A error anymore. Okay, so because the random number is from 0 to 1, so you will have that exactly. Okay, so that is how you deal with this generating this discrete random variable. Okay, so we will okay, so this part here, of course you can see that we have to create the column X on the right hand side. You can actually do get similar result by using index match function to match back to the left hand side. Okay, so to match back to the left hand side, you can use index match function. So we will stop here for the VLOOKUP for approximate matching, and then see you again in the next video.